Good morning, members of the press, members of Trinidad and Tobago Media. Welcome to today's media briefing hosted by the TTFA. Today's focus, obviously, women's football. I want to thank you for taking the time out to attend on this Friday morning. With me, to my left, is head coach of the Trinidad and Tobago Women's Under-20 and Under-17 team, Mr. Richard Hood. He's going to be here to give us an idea as to how preparations have been dating back to late 2019, when he took up duties preparing both teams for upcoming CONCACAF qualification, as well as some disclosure will be made about the team's preparations heading into tournaments in March, February, later this year, as well as mid-year for the under-17s. At this point in time, the women's under-20 team and under-17 team have been in training. Coach Hood also completed some scouting sessions ahead of the under-20 qualifiers that will be held in Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic, later in February. At this time, without further ado, I will allow Mr. Hood to give some opening remarks following his appointment, and then we take questions from the media. Coach Hood.
Hi. Good morning to the media. We began preparations on the 17th of December, all right, with some screening sessions at the St. Mary's ground, mainly essentially for the under-17s, because that was actually my mandate at the time, the under-17s. Subsequent to that, we had under-20s joining us. Also, we did some screenings in Tobago, right, for both groups. We had quite a bit kids coming out and trying out for the teams. And of course, we have since then finalized our local group going forward with the under-17s and the under-20s. All right. We have a very difficult task ahead of us, all right, particularly with the under-20s. The situation that exists at present, Panama and Costa Rica have been awarded host of the CONCACAF finals. Therefore, they are automatically, right, they are automatically qualifiers. So that means there are only two spots available. All right. That means we have to fight with America, with Mexico, Canada. With Canada. All right, those are, of course, the top teams in the region. So,
AT also.
AT as well, that's right. AT is an emerging force. All right. So we have a very difficult task ahead of us, but we are working hard. All right. We are trying, we are going out to do the best that we can. All right. In terms of our preparation, in terms of going into the tournament, we anticipate as certainly that we would get into the knockout phase, and then we see where we go from there.
All right, thank you, Coach. So just before I take questions from the media, allow me to also announce that the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association has confirmed and finalized a training camp for the U-20 women's team prior to the start of that tournament in Santo Domingo. So our first game in that group, which the group comprises of Haiti, Panama, and Cayman Islands, we play Panama in our opening game on February 23rd. Prior to that, from February 11th, a training camp will begin for the U-20 squad leading up to that opening game. So the team will have approximately 12 days in Santo Domingo to acclimatize prior to their opening game. Of course, the final of that tournament, so there are going to be four groups contested during that tournament in Santo Domingo, and the final will be played on March 8th. Of course, as Coach mentioned earlier, because of the fact that Costa Rica and Panama have been awarded hosting rights for the FIFA Under-20 Women's World Cup, there are only two teams that will qualify from this CONCACAF qualifying stage for that World Cup. Of course, also the Under-17 Women's team, they continue to be in training. As a matter of fact, this weekend they are training camps for both teams here in Trinidad, and their preparations will continue leading up to their tournament, which starts March 20th to April 5th at a venue to be determined by CONCACAF. With that said, we now open the floor to questions. Please use the microphone.
Coach Mark Pusher from Trinidad Press. Given that situation, in terms of the limited places available for the national outfit in terms of qualifying for the CONCACAF tournament, is that you are taking a more system approach to this preparation, because realistically we know there's a very strong chance of advancing.
My mandate at the moment is this tournament, all right? Long term, we would meet with the technical committee following the tournament, and we'll decide how we go going forward. If I'm still in the position, of course, all right? These things will be decided following the tournament. At the moment, we are very much focused on the tournament.
Walt Alibi, Guardian. With this, difficult, challenging period ahead, have you been doing a little research on the Mexicans, the teams that will be in your group, to which you we will have to contest against?
I would have to say no. At the moment, we are very much focused on what we have to do for our team. All right. We started screenings and whatnot. We have kids that came out, a number of them who have been in the program previously. What we have found is that the fitness levels is not where we want it to be. The aggression, we have to do a lot of work on getting the team up to a level that they can compete in at international football, particularly at CONCACAF level, as opposed to regionally. All right. So our focus at the moment is really getting us into a position where we can play, compete. All right. Not so much on the opposition. We will focus on the opposition when we get to a level that we can play against the opposition. We are not there yet.
How does the composition of the team look at this point in time? Do you expect players to come in from outside?
Absolutely. The majority of this, the pool that existed prior to my appointment, is based in America. All right. Whether they are Canadian players or American-born players, and not Canada as well. All right. So we anticipate that the majority of the pool going forward, the final selection, actually come from America.
And if I may just add to that also, Walter, based on the recently introduced talent identification program launched by the TTFA, already they've identified some 10 players based in North America who are going to be new additions to the pool for the women's youth teams that obviously Coach Hurdle will have at his disposal.
Coach, we've traveled the show before, having to play against Mexico and teams like that. Do you see it as a personal challenge, or do you feel pressured by it?
Not really. As a coach, you're always pressured going into games, going into tournaments, and you're never really satisfied with the preparation, regardless of how much work you've done. Always question what else you could have done to prepare the team. All right, so that's the kind of pressure I feel. All right, for me, it's about carrying the program forward. It's about the improvement of the level of play of the players, the level of fitness, etc. We know that the other nations at this time are ahead of us. We are aware of that. All right, we know that the Mexicos, they are ahead of us, the Mexicos, the Costa Ricas, whatever. All right. We know that we have a lot of work to do. Good. But we also know that we have the talent and we have the capability of getting our girls to where we want them to be. All right. And that is our challenge. All right. So that's the pressure for me. All right. Raising the levels of the competitiveness of the players. And what I've encountered since I've joined recently is there is some reluctance on some players' part to be part of the thing at the moment, whatever reason, I don't know. So we are in the process of also trying to get these players back into the pool, to ensure that we have best possible players going forward represent Trinidad and Tobago.
Given the gap you identified in the level the Trinidad and Tobago football team is at and they're going to compete at the tournament, how difficult do you do you think your goal of advancing to the playoff stage is going to be?
It is going to be difficult, all right? Panama is an emerging force. Haiti is an emerging force, all right? I would suggest that Caymans would probably be the weakest team in the group. So we expect to certainly beat the Caymans, all right? We can get results off of the other teams as well, good. So really, it's three teams going forward out of the group of four, all right? So basically, we just simply have to beat Caymans, all right? But having said that, the goal is really to beat everybody. Right, that's the goal. Whether it's achievable or not, is we will see. Right, but we will be going into the tournament with that mindset. We are going to go in there to qualify in the knockout stage, at least get to the knockout stage, and then we will see where we go there.
Good day, Mr. Hood. Jonathan Ramlan from the Newsday.
Sure.
Looking beyond the tournament, what would be your long goal if you serve as coach, yeah, for the team, looking beyond the tournament?
Looking beyond the tournament, my long-term goal would be to have a continuous program run, right, at the national level. What would, I've advocated in my previous stints as national coach that this is absolutely necessary for girls football, right, from the much younger age as well. We need to get our girls playing much more, right? Unfortunately, right, no disrespect to the Wolf League or whatever, right? Wolf League does not prepare women to play internationally, all right? It's only the Football Association can do that with the arrangement that we have in Trinidad and Tobago at the moment. It's only the Football Association. So it is our responsibility, the Football Association, that is, to develop our young girls. Our girls do not play enough, not like boys. They don't sweat. They don't go in you know, school and play a small goal or after school or in the park or whatever. All right, that's a big problem with the women's program. Good. So we have to set up our program going forward where we are training continuously. Good. And every cycle we're producing quality teams. All right, for qualification for World Cup.
Coach, I don't know if you or Sean could answer this, but scam that you all are going. Do you all expect to play any kind of friendly match, any warm up match?
Absolutely. Sorry for interrupting. We already have three games carded for that camp. All right. If I remember, well, the dates will vary because the camp dates have actually changed a bit. But we have three games scheduled. One of them would be against the Dominican Republic U-20 team. Right. We're going to play another club team perhaps, and we're actually going to play a boys team as well.
Coach, when you expect to name your final squad, and how much has the team been reduced going into the camps? You said you had these initial training sessions in December. How far down have the teams been reduced in terms of going into the camps?
Well, in terms of the reduction, I think we had over 50 to 60 kids trying out at present between the both teams. At present, we probably have about 30 kids training consistently at the moment. All right. Of that 30, I think we have about 17. That's not correct. About 15 U-20s. All right, and that's between Trinidad, Tobago, the Tobago kids as well. All right. So this weekend's camp is effectively mainly for the U-20s. Good. So this will give me a better idea of where we are, particularly pertaining to the Tobago kids, because when we screened them and they came over, we brought them over last weekend as well. We found that their fitness levels was way below what it ought to be as well. So it's an opportunity for us to where they are in terms of integrating with the local group and see where. What work we have to do with them. We have already given them a program to a physical program to complete across here as well. All right, but it's about just integrating the both groups together, and then we'll be in a better position to finalize where we go.
And the Trichy,
Santo Domingo. Sorry.
Further questions?
We have a favorable position in the sense that we have a group in which we almost seem to come out of. And well, of course, we have up for the really knockout stage. I suppose that focus might be the teams that could potentially come out of the other groups.
Exactly. All right. It's the thing about it is that the difficulty is that when we have qualified from the group stage, right, first, second, or third, we don't know where we're going to be, who we're going to be, the opponent is going to be. So we can't think about that just yet. All right. When we get into the tournament and we see how we go in, and then we can see, right. But we have very good ideas about all the opponents, right? How their style of play, etc. Good, and of course we are going to get footage of them as well. Go, so we will be in a position to plan effectively.
Coach, right. The team, the players having to meet the squad when they go to the tournament. Is that a little bit about jointed to your preparation itself?
It is a it makes the situation a bit more difficult, right? Fortunately for us is that we have this opportunity. This is actually probably the first time I've ever had this opportunity before whilst coaching a national women's team, right? Where we have this opportunity of a 10-day camp leading into the tournament. But normally I would get to a tournament and now seeing a player for the first time, right? That we have had that those situations before, but now we have 10 days with that we can work with them and we could get them organized and get the entire team organized. That augurs well for us.
Right, Coach, just allow me to ask you, the fact is that you've come into this position with experience. You were assistant coach at the under-17 Women's World Cup in 2010. You, as head coach, you took the women's senior team to the semi-final stage of the 2016 CONCACAF Olympic qualifiers. But based on these appointments, now what are your reaction to this opportunity being presented to you again to serve?
Well, it's always a measure of pride for me to serve my country. It's an honor, all right? I always look forward to working with young kids particularly, you know, to see the development of the youngsters. You know, it was a joy for me working with the 17 team particularly. You know, we formed a really close unit with that group, and we that continues today, you know, the relationships that we formed at that time. And those players went on to do well. The majority of them went on to represent the country at senior level, those locally based ones, that is. So it's a source of joy for me with the national team, all right? So it's something that I always look forward to. Okay? Going forward, I'm just hopeful that, you know, there is the continuity and we can actually do the things that we need to do to move women's football forward.
Do we have any further questions? All right, Coach, I want to take the opportunity to thank you for being here with us this morning. And members of the press, thank you very much.
Good. Thank you.